The purpose of this video is to help you submit metadata with a new MG-RAST job submission using the metadata template file provided on the upload page. The template can also be used to update metadata of existing completed jobs, although that is not discussed in this video. The template is occasionally revised, so please download a new copy every time you submit a job. For the same reason, you may notice minor variations in the current template version from what is depicted in this video. Let's look at the template. It is an Excel spreadsheet containing several sheets and numerous fields on each sheet. Note that the text and cells have been enlarged and reformatted for purposes of this demonstration. Do not change the names of sheets and only enter text in blank cells. Some fields are freeform, but most require either a very specific format or a term exactly chosen from a specific list. This will be checked by a validation program in MG-RAST, but as you will see, there are detailed instructions to help you. Notice the tabs for each sheet. After the sheet called README, there are sheets named Project and Sample, and multiple library sheets. And after that, the rest begin with EP, which signifies Environmental Package. All jobs require the Project and Sample sheets. Library information is also always required, but different sequencing techniques require different library metadata, so use the Library Metagenome sheet for shotgun sequencing, or the Library MyMark Survey sheet for amplicon sequencing. Finally, you must choose an environmental package, even if you do not supply detailed environment information. In this video, we discuss only minimal requirements for metadata, but more metadata always increases the potential of post-annotation analysis. Now we move to the project sheet. In this sheet and all the others, field labels occupy the first row, and required fields are indicated in red color. The second row gives a further explanation of each field, including format instructions. On the project sheet, complete exactly one row to organize your job submission under a project heading within MG-RAST. The project name field here in the spreadsheet is identical with step 2 of data submission on the upload web page, shown here briefly. You can use the name of an existing project of your own, but you may not use a project name already used by someone else. Note that the project ID field is provided for your use and will not be used by MG-RAST. Now we quickly complete the remaining required fields of the project sheet, which are straightforward. On the sample sheet, now shown, you must fill one or more rows reflecting your experimental design and sequence files. Look at the second row carefully because it explains what values or formats are permitted for your entries. You should complete one row for each experimental sample represented by the sequence files of your job submission. Give a distinct name to each sample with the sample name field. Later, you will exactly copy these sample names to the library sheet to identify the origin of each submitted sequence file. Sample names must also be copied to environmental package sheets. As before, an ID field is provided for your use, and will not be used by MG-RAST. Latitude, longitude, country, and location are easy to complete, but again, note that your entries must conform to the format details in the second row. In particular, use only positive and negative numbers for longitude and latitude, not directions like north, south, east, or west. For date, time, and time zone, make sure to use the indicated format. For time zone, please note that conventional abbreviations like GMT or EST will not be accepted. Instead, use the Coordinated Universal Time System, abbreviated UTC. To the right, there are several other required fields. For biome, feature, and material, you must search the web pages indicated in the second row. The Environment Ontology website now shown provides a systematic vocabulary of appropriate terms. In the left sidebar, notice the top-level categories biome, feature, and material. From each category, find one term appropriate to your data and copy the preferred name exactly as it appears on the website. Lastly, specify an appropriate environmental package for your data. Use one of the EP names from the second row, exactly as it appears. Next, you will use one of the two library sheets to provide technical information for your sequencing run or runs. Use the library metagenome sheet for shotgun sequencing and the library MIMARC survey sheet for amplicon sequencing. The required fields are identical in both versions of the library sheet. We will look at the library MIMARC survey sheet. You should complete one row per metagenome. If your sequence files are not multiplexed, then you will have one row per sequence file. Give a descriptive name to each metagenome and specify the experimental sample it originates from, using a sample name that you previously assigned on the sample sheet. Specify the sequence file in which reads for the metagenome are recorded. The file example-reads.fna has already been uploaded to MG-RAST for purposes of this demonstration. On this library sheet, always enter MIMARC survey for the investigation type field. On the library metagenome sheet, you would enter metagenome in the corresponding field. For sequencing method, choose one of the alternatives in row 2. Finally, locate the sheet or sheets for the environmental package or packages previously chosen. On each relevant EP sheet, enter the exact sample name or names, one per row, that you specified before and that belong with that environmental package. In this demonstration, we have only one sample, and it uses the environmental package water, which happens to be the last sheet. We are entering minimal information here, but we urge you to complete as many fields as possible. The spreadsheet is now done, but for demonstration, we introduce a common mistake to show what happens when the validator fails. EST does not conform to the required time zone format, so this change will make the spreadsheet fail validation. Notice the following steps. We save the spreadsheet locally. We upload it to our inbox. We attempt to select it, but it does fail, and notice that the validator provides a detailed explanation. We return to Excel to fix the problem. We again save the local version. Before uploading again, we first delete the old version from our inbox, and then we proceed as before, first uploading the spreadsheet, and then selecting it. This time, the spreadsheet passes the validator, and the message from MG-RAST indicates that the metadata spreadsheet will apply to a new job rather than an existing job. Now we can continue through the rest of the job submission process. The information in this video is also available in print on the MG-RAST blog page addressing metadata. You can also download a completed example spreadsheet from that page.